Good morning students, welcome to biology class. On today's session we are going to be continue the topic of tissues. In the last class we already discussed about the simple permanent tissue. Yes, right? The simple permanent tissue, where it is differentiated from the permanent tissues. The permanent tissues are having differentiated cells, and the simple permanent tissue is also having a different types of tissues are there. What are the different types of tissues we discussed in the last class? About the parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. We already discussed. And we discussed about the structures of the parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Yes, right? And we discussed with the help of the two diagrams also. Lateral cross section surface and lateral transverse section. We discussed in the last class. And today's class we are going to be discussed about that the epidermal cells activity. In the last class we discussed about how we can perform the epidermal cell activity. Yes, right? In this session we are going to be observing the epidermal cells from the which leaf. In the last class we discussed with the help of rheolith, but the rheolith is not available. And now I took one garden plant leaf, that is nothing but spider plant. This was the spider plant. This spider plant, when you will be placed only some of the plant in a soil, within a 2 to 3 months the whole plant will be spread. How the spider will be form the web like that, it will be keep on growing. This was the spider plant and this was the garden show plant only. With the help of these spider plant, now we are going to be observing the epidermal cells. Yes, and in the last class we discussed that the epidermal cells are having strong and it will give the strength for the plant. Why? Because the epidermal cells are only the upper surface layers of the leaf or the stem, and it needs to be strong. Why? Because not to enter the different type of infection into the plant or stem, and it needs to be absorb only a possible rays and light rays enters into the plant. And how we can observe the epidermal cells, and what are the cells are going to be bind with along the epidermal cells, we can be discussed in this session. What was the aim? Observing the epidermal cells from spider plant. Yes. Next, what are the materials you needed? The materials are spider plant, microscope, cover slip, slide, and next watch glass. Glycerin, water, etc. Okay, and the procedure we will be start. Procedure. Yes. First thing, take the spider plant, and I am going to be plug the one stem of the one leaf of the spider plant, and I will be kept it aside. Now I am going to be forcefully to drag the leaf into cut into two pieces. Look here. Yes. A thin small layers. Did you observe it? Yes. That the thin small layers of the leaf only I am going to be collect. Now here I am going to be observe lateral surface and lateral view and surface view. Lateral view means a thin layer we will be observed. Now I drag it very forcefully. A small transparent layer will become. That small transparent layer I am going to be kept in a watch glass under the water. Did you observe it here? That was the small transverse leaf. Now I am going to be add a water. Why? Because not to dry the cells of the stem. Yes. And now I am going to be clean the slide with the help of the alcohol and water. Let slide will be dry for some time. And after drying, I am going to be keep the Did you observe it? This was the lateral view of the spider plant. Okay, na? And next, I am going to be add the glycerin. Just 2 drops of glycerin and kept it aside for 2 minutes. Why? Because it needs to be dried. Yes. And now continue with the procedure. Here, cut the leaf gently and forcefully into 2 pieces. Collect the thin layer of leaf. Thin layer of leaf. Keep the leaf on the slide, add glycerin, dry it for 2 minutes. After, cover with cover slip and observe it under the microscope. Yes, this was the procedure. And now the slide dried. Now I added some glue with the help of the cover slip. I covered it without the air bubbles. How we did in the last time, like that, without the air bubbles you should be add the cover slip. If any excess will be present, you should be removed with the help of the cotton. Yes, look how we kept it. Okay, and now dry it for 2 minutes, and after I'm going to be observed under the microscope. How we observed before, the transverse section, cross section of a leaf, of a stem, like that only. And next, and I observed with the help of the eyepiece, and now I'm going to be check the lenses the help of the 100x and 40x, I am going to be observe it. Yes, and when we are going to observe the 10x, I observe the lateral view. but I need to be observe the surface view also, no? At that time, I am going to be use the 40x lenses. Now I change the lenses. First, I will discuss about the 40x lenses. Which structure I observed at the time of 40x, 10x? Means lateral view. This was the lateral view. Okay, I observe the structure like this. And next, I am going to be observed with the help of 60x lenses. Which structure we need to be observed? Yes, I observe the surface view means like this. This was the surface. Lateral means like this. Okay. Surface view. The leaf we will be cut like this. No, at the time we can be observe the surface view. I observe this was the surface view. Lateral view, surface view. And here a common structure is there. That is nothing but guard cells. Guard cells. Inside the guard cells, what will be present? This is nothing but stroma. Stroma means stomata. Yes. Children, we already discussed when from the 6th class to we observed when we observed the photosynthesis experiment, photosynthesis lesson, the two cells are going to be opening and closing mechanism for cellular respiration. That the cells are nothing but guard cells. The guard cells will be like this only. If it wants to take the water, will be open like this. At that time, the water will go to inside, the air will go to inside. The CO2 will go to inside and the close will be happen. Around the guard cells, the epidermal cells will be present, no? These are the epidermal cells. These epidermal cells are going to be absorb the water. When the guard cells are open, the water will be come outside. That water will be absorbed by around the epidermal cells, and again after cellular respiration, again the guard cells will be open, the water will go to inside. These epidermal cells are going to be helpful when at the time of drought condition, habitat condition, they are having one habitat. If more water will be available, the plants will absorb water. If less water will be available, at that time these epidermal cells will become more thick cells and not to avoid the water to evaporate to outside. That's why these epidermal cells are going to be playing a very important role in a plant, and these guard cells are going to be helpful for cellular respiration. By these stomata cells only the plant can be breathe. That the CO2 will go to inside and the O2 will come to outside. That O2 only human beings are going to be take to breathe. And next, these guard cells will act as lungs. These will be act as an two lungs. The lungs will be contract and relaxation, no? Like that, the guard cells also will be open and get relaxed. At the time, these epidermal cells will play an important role, and these epidermal cells will be protects. It protects all the parts of the plants not to cause any harmful. And aerial plants, the plant which will be secrete a waxy and a water resistant layer also will be depend on these epidermal cells only. And today's class is going to be completed, children. And tomorrow's session we will be discuss some more points on the epidermal cells and the complex tissues we discuss. And let's revise a little bit topic. And today's activity is nothing but the observing the epidermal cells from the spider plant. And why we need to be observe the epidermal cells? The epidermal cells are going to be protect for the plant not to evaporate the water to outside, and it is having a good mechanism. That mechanism is nothing but cellular respiration, and water resistant capacity also will be there for the epidermal cells. Through this activity we can be known that the epidermal cells are having a capability to hold the water when at the time of drought conditions also. By this activity we can concluded that, and today's session completed. Tomorrow session we will be discuss with the next topic. And be hygienic, students. Don't go to outside. Be safe by yourself and be healthy. Eat healthy food also. Thank you, children.